It sounds crazy. You know, here's a big ball of rock with stuff coming out of it. And it's like, therefore, God is amazing. It sounds crazy, but that's true, and it's what happens. And the medievals understood that. They could see the sun, and they could see the stars, and they said, wow, this is the heavens. This is truly the heavens. My name is Josiah Nance, and I teach astronomy for Roman Roads. The first aspect of the class focuses on the medieval cosmology. They had a much different view of the heavens than we did. They called it the heavens. They didn't call it space. The thing about the medievals is they believed that Earth was at the center of the universe, the orbit of the moon and beyond. That was perfection. That was where the angels danced. That was where life and light and music and joy and personality and all of that reigned in the heavens. Literally, they were of course incorrect, but metaphorically, and if you will, spiritually, the medievals were actually correct. The heavens are in fact heavenly. It really is full of love. It really is full of light. The second aspect of the class builds off of that, and we study the motion of the stars and the sun and the moon and the phases of the moon and that sort of thing. In other words, we study astronomy from Earth, but with the understanding that the world is in fact as the medieval said it was, that it was full of life and it was full of God's personality, and he has revealed himself in his creation. Most astronomy classes, if you just take a regular, you know, online astronomy class or a secular astronomy class from a high school or university, they're going to teach you facts. They're going to teach you that the Earth is 93 million miles away from the Sun, that there are certain things happening in Jupiter's clouds. They're incredible facts, but the point is not to stop those facts. The point is to look beyond those facts and to tie it in with the medieval worldview and say, the medievals believed this. We know that this is now the case. How are they both true? How is the world really full of God's glory and full of life and light? And therefore, what the class ultimately does is to align the students' loves to God himself and to point you to the stars and beyond the stars into his country.